All right, what's happening, everybody? I know it's been a while since I've done a vlog, but we got some guys that came in. Justin Drones and Mouse came down to fly at Quad Castle today. So we're gonna get out, do some ripping. But thank you everybody for tuning in to the Detroit FPV show every Sunday night, 9 p.m. You can check that out on YouTube. And thank you everybody who subscribed to the channel. Thank you everybody for watching, commenting, liking, all that good stuff. And I really appreciate it. But we're gonna get here out to the Bandos in Detroit again. I'm actually in the parking lot right now, so I'm about to hop out. We'll say what's up to everybody, and then we'll go and do some ripping. All right, we can already hear the quads ripping. We got Bando, the Bando dog. What's up, Bando? It's like Dronesen's in the goggles. What's up, Dronesen?
What's up, man?
Got Mouse in the house. What's up, brother? How you doing today?
Doing good, doing good. First time here, so.
Awesome, man.
Hard. And
what's up, what's up? Let's check it out.
Finally moved to 6S, so.
Oh, damn, dude.
Yeah, man.
Look at that thing. Very sharp, dude. I like the gold motors, though. V-locks, yeah. Are they the V-locks or whatever?
No, they're the Zing Cybers with
Zing
like
Cyber.
10mm bearings in them, yeah.
Nice, dude.
Yeah, so got about two packs through it, so.
Test it out in the right spot, right? Got Justin Drones in the house. The man behind the
show and tell. I got a show and tell.
These guys are into it too.
Check it out, dude. I got this guy.
What do we got here? And oh, it's like a Cinewhoop kind of thing.
Yeah.
What is that?
It's a iFlight ProTech 35.
Okay.
3.5 inch prop.
I like the.
So it's kind of like a Cinewhoop, but.
No, looks a little bit more
these
beefy
are like,
though.
Just like guards, you know, so it flies looks like better than it flies like a regular.
5-inch motors almost on it, right? Big 220
they're
what?
Kind of the same thing as his motors.
22 somethings.
Yeah, check these out. These are 2204 FPV cycles. This is a Cinesplore.
Okay.
So it's an FPV cycle squirt, basically.
This one is a.
This is a TBS Source 1 4S. And that's my new 6S, well, the frame I've had for a little bit. It's the FPV cycle prototype frame.
Nice, man. So, yeah. A lot of different variety here.
Yeah, man.
Got the Cinewhoop, and then he's flying the Apexes, eh? You got the twins.
Yeah.
Now, are you running air units? It looks like one's got a Vista, one's got an air. What do you like better? What are you thinking? Because I got both, too.
Vista. I mean, the Vista's definitely smaller and lighter weight and nice.
And you don't got to carry that second antenna.
Yes,
and you don't got to carry the giant TPU mount to hold your antenna.
Yeah, do you guys notice a difference in video quality?
I've never had an air unit, man, but I outflew him when we were chasing. Although
I honestly think my air unit gives me better footage.
I think it gives me better, like,
it looks better.
Do you think that's the camera, or do you think that?
My thought is it's the two antennas, right? Because they're both, you're getting direction that you're not getting with one.
Digital. I feel like either you're getting it or you're not. I don't know, man.
I feel like I had better, like, when I went to Perfect, I flew the 3-inch, which has a Vista, and then I threw the 5-inch, which has this air unit.
Yep.
And I got a little better quality picture with the Vista.
That's what I've been finding, too.
Yeah.
Now, I do like to rip my Vista because it seems like my Vista, like you said, it's lighter.
Yeah.
So that couple grams, I can do maneuvers different.
It's like 30 grams.
Is that what it is?
Well, okay, so you figure 10 grams for the unit.
Okay.
5 grams for the camera. So that's 15 grams. Then that this giant TPU mount, I printed one for him, and it was like 11 grams.
Okay.
So now you're at like 25. And then you figure 5 grams more for the camera, and you're at 30 grams difference.
Gotcha. So that's where I'm feeling it. Because it does feel like it's a little bit more locked for me when I'm flying the Vista. But, I mean, they both feel good. You know, I mean, I can't complain on either one. But right now, looks like we got Dronesen's quad hiding over here. He's flying the Bando Slayer with the Zing 1800s, that iFlight stack. Looks like he's got a DJI unit on there, the air unit, and a 7 Black. Here we got Dronesen in action. He's rocking it out. Got that DJI with the beautiful grip tape on there. Got batteries charging. Extel showed up to rip with us. What's happening, Extel?
What's up?
How you doing, brother?
Busy.
Busy? Yeah, I got out today, though. See what you got here. Tell everybody what you're looking at here.
A little Squirt V2 action.
It's a little Cinewhoop if anybody's interested in one of those. They are pretty sweet. That's the one, too, the Squirt.
And the Brock Lee frame.
Broccoli in the wild. That's called the Player One, right? Is that the name of that one?
Oh, yeah. She's pretty stout.
Awesome, man. Good to see you out today, brother.
Hell yeah.
Awesome, man. Rip it up.
Like
all right, we got drones in FPV. What's happening, brother?
What's up, man?
My co-host on the Detroit FPV show every Sunday night at 9 p.m. Make sure you guys check that out. This week's challenge was pretty fun.
Oh, Rip a new spot. One pack edit.
Yeah, man. How'd it go in there? How was your Bando flight?
Oh.
Nice, man.
Hot battery.
Pushing it. Beautiful day out here in Detroit, though. And we are in Detroit today, hanging with the Detroit Quad crew on a Bando Sunday. So we'll see you guys on the next video.